Welcome to IST, the official YouTube channel of Indian Society of Toxicology. Today we are discussing about scorpion sting and its clinical manifestation and management. Scorpions live in warm, dry regions throughout India. Everywhere we can see scorpions. Scorpion sting is an acute, life-threatening, time-limiting medical emergency, especially in villages. You can get it, this scorpion stings, even in the cities. Among the 86 species of scorpions in India, there are two scorpions are very important clinically, but there are a lot of other things which may produce milder version of the clinical features. One is Mesobuthus tamilus, there is an Indian red scorpion, and another one is Palamnius Swammer Dami. Are the medical important? That's a black type of scorpion. These two are most important among Indian species of scorpions. There are 86 species. Many are unknown to medical practitioners, but most of them will have similar clinical finding. Scorpion stings are primarily due to accidental contact with scorpion. They never come and give sting to us. Rarely, most of the time it is by handling them or trodden them on can produce scorpion stings. There are two important species we have already discussed. One is a red scorpion, another one is black scorpion. Both are dangerous. This is Indian red scorpion picture. Another one is Palamnius Swammer Dami, that is another species which is black in color. All the scorpion venoms produces stimulation to alpha receptors in our blood vessels and cardiovascular system. The venom contains numerous free amino acids in very good quantities. They contain serotonins, hyaluronic acid, various other enzymes which can act on trypsinogen. The toxin acts by opening sodium channels at presynaptic nerve terminals and inhibiting calcium-dependent potassium channels. This will produce an autonomic surge and autonomic storm. You know that autonomic nervous system produces tachycardia, increase blood pressure. All these things are the clinical features. We'll see what are the features. Alpha receptors stimulation by these toxins plays a major role, resulting in high BP, high heart rate, myocardial dysfunction syndrome, cardiac failure, and pulmonary edema. Later, patient produces develops hypotension and cold extremities. When the alpha receptors are stimulated in our blood vessels and cardiovascular system, it produces very high heart rate. It may go to supraventricular tachycardia also. What happens after that is the contraction become ineffective. When the heart rate increases, the ejection fraction slowly comes down. Initially, it may be trying to compensate. The ejection fraction will try to compensate with the tachycardia and increases the BP. But later, heart fails because of tachycardia. There will be cardiac dysfunction and hypotension. There are different types of receptors in our body, in our blood vessels. Alpha receptor, alpha 1, alpha 2 receptors. Beta receptors are beta 1, beta 2, beta 3. Here we are mainly targeting, these venoms are mainly targeting on alpha receptors. They are mainly present in the blood vessels. That produces vasoconstriction. On the heart, it produces tachycardia. So alpha receptors are very important here. Alpha 1 receptors mainly seen in the blood vessels, then heart, then prostate and pilomotor smooth muscles. In that, blood vessel and heart is very important. Patient can have tachycardia and increased BP during the acute phase. Later patient present with severe hypotension and shock. The type of sympathetic or adrenergic receptors are alpha 1 and beta receptors. We have already discussed. Here alpha receptors are stimulated excessively by this venom and produces severe tachycardia and autonomic storm. We'll see what are the clinical findings seen in autonomic storm or unexplained or unwanted alpha receptor stimulation. Patient can have severe vomiting, salivation, sweating, priapism, and later patient can have bradycardia and hypotension shock. Tachycardia, hypertension, myocardial dysfunction, pulmonary edema, and shock are the major clinical features of autonomic storm. So that will be the most important in emergency room. When the patient come with a sting, and if the patient is having tachycardia and hypertension, we have to always suspect about scorpion sting. Later, because of myocardial dysfunction, they develop shock also. Hypotension and bradycardia can be countered within 1 to 2 hours of sting due to cholinergic stimulation also. Most of the patients develop pulmonary edema because of the cardiac failure. It occurs after 30 minutes if the patient is not getting adequate treatment. It occurs because of the myocardial dysfunction. So, autonomic storm indicated by vomiting, salivation, sweating, and later patient can have high BP, tachycardia, then patient can have hypotension, shock, pulmonary edema. Ultimately, if they don't get treatment, most of the patients will develop complications because of shock. Other clinical findings are, in the coagulation cascade, it can produce alteration there and can have disseminated intravascular coagulation. That can be picked up by elevated PTNR, elevated APTT, low fibrinogen. Most of the patients will have severe bleeding tendency. Then patient can have systemic inflammatory response syndrome and multi-organ dysfunction. That is mostly occurring due to the late phase of the poisoning because of the hypotension, vascular leak, and ARDS-like features. Patient can have multi-organ dysfunction syndrome. Most of the patients will experience severe pain at the site of sting. That itself can produce some amount of anxiety, tachycardia, vasovagal attacks. All these things are possible. Very rarely, patient can have anaphylaxis. That is possible in any sting. Any poisoning, you can get anaphylaxis. Acute injection of some protein to our body, patient can have anaphylaxis also. So all these things are possible, but anaphylaxis is very, very rare in scorpion stings. You can see here, there are nearly 5 stages for this disease. First stage, you can have sweating, salivation, midriasis, priapism, hypertension, hypotension, cold extremities. Second stage, you can have hypertension, tachycardia, cold extremities. Third stage, you can have tachycardia, hypotension, pulmonary edema, cold extremities. Stage 4, you can have massive pulmonary edema. Stage 5, you can have warm extremities, tachycardia, hypotension, pulmonary edema, gray pallor, that is warm shock. All these things are due to the acute alpha receptor stimulation, and that produces vasoconstriction and tachycardia. This is an initiation of this problem, and later patient can have cardiac failure because of this high degree of heart rate or unwanted tachycardia. Patient develops hypotension, shock, and multi-organ dysfunction syndrome sets in, and all other complications can occur. So it should be treated as any other tachycardia or hypotension in emergency room, but prazosin has got a very important role in this problem because it's an alpha blocker. It's one of the commonly used drug, but remember, alpha blocker which is available in our countries, most of them are delayed release, so slow release tablet. That should not be used in this emergency. That we'll see. Now we'll see the general management of scorpion sting. Like any other case, come to emergency room, we have to take care of the patient's airway, because most of these patients can have some secretions in the oral cavity. That should be cleared. There will be tachycardia and tachypnea because of the fear. Patient can have respiratory alkalosis. Circulation should be taken care of, because some patients can have high BP, some patients can have hypotension. Both should be tackled according to the clinical scenario. There is no change from airway, breathing, circulation management even in scorpion sting, but specific treatments are available. The next important thing is pain management. So most of these patients will have severe pain, that should be treated with local ice packs. Lignocaine injection can be given at the site. Lignocaine should not be given along with adrenaline. Should be lignocaine 1% or 2% can 1% can be given in the local site. Pain relief should be given by NSAIDs, not by tramadol and all. NSAIDs are the ideal choice for inflammatory conditions like this local stings. So local ice packs, xylocaine infiltration around the local site, NSAID should be given. Then if the patient develop hypotension, like any other hypotension in emergency room, we can start IV normal saline 30 ml per kg infusion, and later depending on the clinical scenario we can give continuous infusion. But remember, normal saline is the best treatment option. And if the patient does not improve with normal saline, if the patient is having tachycardia, go for noradrenaline. If the patient is having bradycardia with hypotension, go for dopamine. So initial treatment is for hypotension is fluid. And if the patient develops pulmonary edema during the treatment, we have to treat the patient with diuretics. Diuretics can be given as an infusion because most of these patients can have sometimes hypotension also. So if we give bolus, sometimes patient can have exacerbated response in the BP. So infusion will be better in this type of patients. Now antivenom is available, we'll discuss about that. The most important treatment in scorpion sting who is having autonomic storm, that is prazosin. It's an alpha blocker. Prazosin is a competitive postsynaptic alpha 1 adrenoreceptor blocker, should be used as a first line of management. Whenever we get a scorpion sting, after taking care of airway, breathing, circulation, immediately start the patient on prazosin, because it is available in India as tablets. It is available as both sustained release and immediate release. We should give immediate release only. We never give sustained release tablets. Even if you crush it, it will not be acting faster because it has got a different technology. Even if you crush the tablets, it will be the tablet will have a coating. So never give a crushed tablet of sustained release. You should give only preparation which can be immediately released. Normal prazosin tablet 1 to 2 mg is available. Since alpha receptor stimulation plays a major role in the autonomic storm, we have to control this alpha stimulation by giving prazosin. Prazosin is available in score tablets 1 mg, 2 mg is available. Sustained release tablet should never be given. The dose is recommended as 30 microgram per kg per dose. Prazosin can be repeated after some time. After 3 hours we can repeat it, or after initiation of the treatment, if the patient still have symptoms, you can give additional tablets immediately if the BP is very high. Never try to give long acting preparation, because these long acting preparations act for 12 to 24 hours. So if afterwards if the patient go to hypotension, then we'll have to tackle that also. So never try to give long-acting preparation at any point of time. You give only short-acting drug, that is a normal preparation, not sustained-release tablets. So prazosin 1 to 2 mg can be given. Scorpion venom anti-serum is available now. It is lipophilized anti-serum. 20 ml vial with 10 ml of saline is available. 20 ml vial with 10 ml diluent is available now. That is lipophilized, monovalent, enzyme, refined equine immunoglobulins. It can be used for red scorpion stings. After reconstitution in 10 ml of this diluent, each ml of scorpion venom antiserum can neutralize nearly 1 mg of red scorpion venom. So that can be given to neutralize this red scorpion venom. If you identify the scorpion as red scorpion, because it's a monovalent antiviral. Another one is CombiPack scorpion venom antiserum. It's lipophilized in 2 ml with 1 ml of diluent. Lipophilized polyvalent enzyme refined equine immunoglobulin. After reconstitution, each ml of scorpion venom antiserum neutralizes not less than 1 ml of venoms. So that also can be used, but it is not available everywhere. So we have to find out the sources of this antivenom in our area. We'll give these details in our description box. Anybody want to know about this one, you can write to us. So we have discussed about scorpion sting and its complications and how to manage this autonomic storm by this scorpion sting in emergency room, how to give anti-serum which is available in India in emergency room. We have discussed everything in detail. Thank you.